Friends, how many times you have heard this cue? Draw your shoulder blades down your back. Relax your trapezius. Pull your shoulder blades down away from the ears. Draw your arm bone into the socket. Namaste, friends. I am Ritesh, and today we will clear this confusion, and it seems everyone has their own reasoning. Some say it is wrong, and some say it's right. If you remember, friends, in all my alignment videos, whether it was foot, knee, hip, or neck, I have always said in alignment, there is never a black and white answer. It all depends because we all are different. Even twins don't have the same characteristics. No single rule is good for all situations. While sometimes it is good to pull the shoulder blades down, and sometimes it's beneficial to pull the shoulder blades up. So those who are new to my channel, please do not forget to watch the alignment videos on foot, knees, hip, neck if you haven't. In fact, I have been using this cue for a very long time, and there is no harm. But today I will let you know why it is important at some times or at some places to use this cue, and at other places you don't need to. In fact, you will do more harm than good. In this video, we will be talking about yoga shoulder alignment. Now, let us try to understand why these cue, that is, draw your shoulder blades down your back. Relax your trapezius. Pull your shoulder blades away from your ears. Draw your arm bones into the socket. Remember, friends, we are not pushing the shoulder blades back and flaring the rib cage or popping the rib cage out. We need to stabilize the spine. Friends, new students generally have tight internally rotated shoulders, also known as upper cross syndrome, right? They have the rounded back. So we have already discussed in the neck alignment, all thanks to the sitting, driving, and texting culture. When new students first come to yoga, they generally either have shoulders that are tight or tense shoulders, as if the shoulders are touching the ears. Hence we here use this cue, keep the shoulder blades down. Friends, there are number of occasions when it is okay to pull the shoulder blades down, also known as scapular depression. For example, if I ask a student to lift the arms up in Urdhva Hastasana, and he lifts the shoulder blade up and tend to bring their shoulder blades toward the ears. Now what's happening? This seems that the student seems quite tensed. And that was the reason we always said shoulders down and relax. That is scapular depression. But remember, we do not force the scapula down, but just ask them to relax. So suppose if some lifts the shoulder blades up and it hurts, then the shoulder blades can be pulled down. For example, friends, if someone is in your class is coming up in this, and he's always stressed on the shoulder. So even if he does any yoga posture, whether it is Urdhva Hastasana, any of the pose, he will be always tense like this. And he always keeps moving like that in this position. And it seems he's always comfortable. But then when you add this cue, keep the shoulder blades down, he feels, oh my God, that's really relaxing. Right? So that is the reason. It depends. You have to see your student. If you feel that his shoulders are always elevated, then that's a nice cue. Okay, let the ear go away from the shoulders. Because sometimes when you push the shoulder blades down, it feels very nice. But in any movement, wherever the arms are lifting up, you will avoid using this cue. So if I am in this position, and if it is this, I can ask a student, okay, keep the shoulder blades down. If he's doing namaste, but if the shoulders are up, I can ask him to keep the shoulder blades down. So let us now try to understand when not to use it. So whenever we lift the arms overhead, the scapula moves up with the humerus. So pulling the shoulders down and lifting the arms up creates colliding in each other, causing compression and thus pinching and friction in the muscles and tendons that envelops the shoulder joint. Just watch this video to get that understanding why we don't want to lift the shoulders up and push the shoulders down. So we are lifting the arms up, but we don't want the shoulders to push down because you are going against the force. So apart from pinching, it also limits the range of motion and decreases stability in the shoulder joint. This movement of the scapula and the humerus in anatomical term is also known as scapulohumeral rhythm, which is the interaction between the scapula, that is your shoulder blades, and the humerus, that is your upper arm. In any of the position where the arm move above the shoulder, you need to be careful, because if you lift the arms up and forcefully push the shoulder down, you're disturbing the rhythm of the glenohumeral rhythm, acromion process, and the acromion process, as they both work in tandem together. Scapulohumeral movement plays a role in any pose where the arms are overhead, including Urdhvahastasana, Virabhadrasana 1, or a tree pose, downward facing dog, or a handstand. So friends, in the next video, I will share with you some asanas, how to do it with shoulder alignment. So do watch my part 2 on shoulder alignment. Friends, if you have something to share or add them into my knowledge about your ideas and suggestions on shoulder alignment, do share it in the comment section below. Thank you for watching my video. Keep smiling. Take care. Namaste.